wadda-wadda, you can just boom boom. Chang, 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 and change your buck. That's the way it should be.
Oh my goodness. how pretty you look.
I do?
Yes.
Make sure she sits in the first seat in the front row.
Oh, okay.
First seat in the front row.
Yeah, and you're sitting right, you're Mildred, right?
Yes.
You're sitting right next to her.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Baruch haba b'shem Adonai, mi'adir al hakol, mi'baruch al hakol, mi'gadol al hakol, mi'varech echatan v'hakala. First in English and then in Hebrew, and after every blessing I say during the ceremony in Hebrew, I'll say the word vinomar. When I say vinomar, all of your friends and all of your loved ones have to say as loudly and enthusiastically as you can, Amen. Praised are you, O Lord our God, who rules the universe, creating the fruit of the vine. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, borek b'ri hagafen vinomar.
Amen.
You can do better than that. I'll give you another chance. Praised are you, O Lord our God, who rules the universe, whose mitzvot add holiness to our lives, and whose will guides us even in the most intimate of our relationships. Praised are you, Lord our God, who sanctifies the people Israel with the wedding canopy and the sacred wedding tradition. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, asher kitchanu b'mitzvotav v'tzivanu ha'arayot, yaser lanu et ha'arusot, v'yitir lanu et ha'nesuot lanu ha'yidei chupa v'kiddushin. Baruch atah Adonai mekadesh amo Yisrael ha'yidei chupa v'kiddushin. V'nomar,
Amen.
That's an idea. David is going to put a wedding ring on Jacqueline's finger, and at which point I am going to say in Hebrew, I'm going to say a Hebrew sentence, but between each word, you have it? I'm going to say a Hebrew sentence, which David will repeat, but between each word, I'm going to say the words, the English words, you say. The reason I say the English words, you say, is because if I say the sentence without interruption, then I will marry Jacqueline. I'm over here for it. I will interrupt the sentence. You put it on the right forefinger. Right forefinger. That's your left. And your forefinger, not your finger. Repeat after me. Hare.
Hare.
You say at.
You say at.
You just, you say at. Say me.
Li.
You say bitabat.
Bitabata.
You say zo.
Zo.
You say kedat.
Kedat.
You say Moshe.
Moshe.
You say to Yisrael.
Yisrael.
By this ring.
By this ring.
You are consecrated to me.
You are consecrated to me.
As my wife.
As my wife.
In accordance with the law of Moses.
In accordance with the law of Moses.
And the people of Israel.
And the people of Israel.
Now you put his ring on there. Say the following. Ani le dodi. The dodi le. I am my beloved, and through God's grace, my beloved is mine. A few moments before we started the ceremony, we sang the ketubah, the traditional Jewish wedding contract. It is written in ancient Aramaic and is over 1,000 years old. And I'm going to read a little bit of it now. בשני בשבת, בחמישה ועשרים יום לחודש טבת, שנת 5760, לבריאת עולם למניין שאנו מונים כאן בעיר אורלנדו, פלורידה, in ancient Aramaic phrase, במדינת אמריקה הצפונית, איך החתן דוד בן שמואל המכונה סיגל, אמר לה להד המדרכת בת שבע בת אברהם אבינו המכונה מלארי, אביא לי לאמצל כדת משה בישראל. Embraced by the love which has brought them together, the Chatan declares to the Kala before this gathering of family and friends, take this ring as a sign of your consecration to me, for by it we are joined to each other according to the laws and traditions of Moses and of the Jewish people. From this sacred moment and throughout our lives, we are devoted and our affection is everlasting. The Kaaba, affirming that love, accepts the ring and declares, I am my beloved's and my beloved is mine. I am woman, you are man, each of us created in God's image, each of us unique and of infinite worth. Now through our shared hopes and promises are joyfully, equally joined together as one. There is an old joke, which I'm convinced had it been written 1,000 years ago, would have been a rabbinical commentary. The joke is of a man who lives in an apartment building and there's a flood in the city. The waters rise to the second floor and a boat comes by. And they say, quick, get on the boat and we'll take you to safety. And the man says, no, I believe in God and God will save me. The waters continue to rise. The man runs to the seventh floor. Another boat comes by. And they say, quick, get on the boat and we'll take you to safety. The man says, no, I believe in God and God will save me. Finally, the waters rise so high that the man runs to the roof. And a helicopter comes by and they drop a rope and they say, quick, climb to the rope, we'll take you to safety. Says, no, I believe in God, and God will save me. The man drowns, goes to heaven, and says to God, I've been a righteous man all my life. Why didn't you help me? And God says, I sent you 2 boats and a helicopter. What's going to happen? Very often in our lives, our help is right there, and we don't see it. A wedding celebrates our help being there and us seeing it. The Midrash, the rabbinic commentary, teaches us that a person, when they are born, has half of their soul taken from their bodies, and it's put into the body of the person they are destined to spend their life with. And we spend our lives trying to find the person who has the other half of our soul. We're very happy, all of us gathered here today, that you two found the other half of your soul. And that's why we wish you Mazel Tov and many, many years of happiness. At this point, I'm going to do the traditional 7 marital blessings. Again, I will say them first in English and then in Hebrew, and say Vinomar and ask you to respond with Amen. Praised are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, creator of the fruit of the vine. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam, borei peri hagafen. Vinomar. Praised are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who created all things for your glory. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, shako bara lichvodo. V'nomar.
Amen.
Praised are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, creator of humanity. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, yotzer ha'adam. V'nomar. Praised are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who created man and woman in your image, fashioning woman from man as his mate, that together they might perpetuate life. Praised are you, O Lord, creator of humanity. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech olam, asher yatzar et adam b'tzalmo, b'tzelem dimutz tavnito, v'hikim lo mimenu binyan adead. Baruch atah Adonai yotzeh Adam. V'nomar.
Amen.
May Zion rejoice as her children are restored to her in joy. Praised are you, O Lord, who causes Zion to rejoice at her children's return. V'ostasis v'tagel ha'akara, v'kibutz v'ane'a v'tokha v'simcha. Baruch atah Adonai.
Amen.
Dear God, grant perfect joy to these loving companions, as you did to the first man and woman in the Garden of Eden. Praised are you, O Lord, who grants the joy of bride and groom. Sameach tisamach reim ahovim, tisamechecha yitzircha b'gan Eden mikedem. Baruch atah Adonai, nesameach atan v'gazla. V'nomar.
Amen.
Praised are you, O Lord our God, King of the universe, who created joy and gladness, bride and groom, mirth, song, delight and rejoicing, love and harmony, peace and companionship. O Lord our God, may there ever be heard in the cities of Judah and in the streets of Jerusalem voices of joy and gladness, voices of bride and groom, the jubilant voices of those joined in marriage under the bridal canopy, the voices of people feasting and singing. Praised are you, O Lord, who causes the bride and the groom to rejoice. Baruch atah Adonai Eloheinu melech haolam Asher barash ason b'simcha chatan v'chalah Kilah rina ditza v'cheva Ava v'yachva v'shalom v'reut Me'era Adonai Eloheinu Yishama v'ara Yehuda v'chutzot Yerushalayim Kos ason v'kos simcha Kol chatan v'kol kalah Kol mitzalot chatanim mechupatam ונערים משתי נגינתם ברוך ה' משמח חתן עם הכלה ונאמר
אמן
Now going to bless you with the traditional blessing of the priest, Birkat Kohanim. It is a three-pronged blessing. I will do each phrase of it first in English and then in Hebrew. And then at the end, everyone will say Amen. May the Lord bless you and guard you.
Yivarechecha Adonai v'yishmerecha.
May the Lord show you favor and be gracious to you.
Ya'er Adonai panav lecha v'chunecha.
May the Lord show you kindness and grant you the ultimate gift, the gift of peace.
Yisa Adonai panav lecha v'yasem lecha lecha shalom.
Ben Omar.
Amen.
We now come to the end of the ceremony. The end of the ceremony, the Jewish wedding ceremony, is the most misunderstood tradition that we have. In a moment, I'm going to put a glass down by your foot, and you will stamp on it and hopefully break it on your first try, use the heel. And everyone will yell Mazel Tov, which means good luck or congratulations. Because of this, most people think that the smashing of the glass is representative of something positive. It actually is a memory of the not-so-wonderful things that have happened to the Jewish people throughout our history. So why do we do it at a wedding? Why do we remember the sad times at a wedding? Judaism is a religion of two things, of balance and of optimism. Even in our happiest moments, we have to remember sad times, just as in our saddest moments, we have to remember our happier times. But it's also a religion of optimism, and it says that just because the two of you have found each other, there is hope and optimism for all of us in the future. And so I put the glass by your foot, and as soon as you stamp it, you will be husband and wife. Mazel tov.
glasses.
Yes, go ahead.
Okay, look right here.
I thought we came up here to consummate the wedding.
We need that. We need our wives over, right?
Not a...
Yeah, we're going to take
Victoria.
Victoria.
Slippery. Slippery.
Are you okay, Victoria?
Her shoes are slippery.
Hey, we need to bring Glenn and Barbara.
welcome as our first couple, Barry Siegel escorting Jessica Mallory. Next on our list, we have Michael Martyr and Carissa Martyr. Please welcome Jim Gissey escorting Karen King. Next, please welcome Steve Siegel and his escort, Maria Gamble. Last but certainly not least on our list of best men and bridesmaids, please welcome Richard Siegel and Allison Martino. Show off. Please welcome the parents of the bride, Deborah and John Mallory. For our next introduction, I need everyone to direct their attention to the back of the room. There she is, the one, the only, Mrs. Sadell Siegel. Wave to everybody for us, Sadell. There she is. Everyone, eyes front, because here they come in the moment you've all been waiting for. Please welcome the brand new Mr. and Mrs. David and Jacqueline Siegel. The first dance is man and wife. They'll be dancing to Celine Dion's The Power of Love.
I'm gonna hold on to you.
note, big round of applause to the bride and groom on all this great-looking wedding party. We're going to give them a second to go find their seats at the head table. Ladies and gentlemen, we have another little traditional thing to take care of. If you see the rather large loaf of bread here right in the middle of the dance floor, that is known as a challah. And Michael Marnard here is going to say a special prayer over this loaf of bread known as the motzi. So if I could have your attention up to the front of the room, please, we're going to turn things over to Michael.
Everybody ready? Baruch atah Adonai, Eloheinu melech haolam, amotzi lechem min haaretz.
Amen. Amen.
There we are. Now, we're going to follow that right up with a few toasts here. We're going to head back to the head table, so I need everybody's eyes back here. Turn the microphone over to Barry Siegel, who is going to be our first best man to propose a toast.
Please raise your glass and let's give a toast to David Jackson on this beautiful wedding day. When I was young, I used to look up to my big brother David, and I used to say, when I get big, I want to be just like him. Except my wife Barbara said that one, I can only get married once. Let's give a toast now to Dave and Jacqueline on this beautiful wedding day. Let's wish them a long and healthy marriage.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we have more toasts to come, but this is the moment you've all really been waiting for. We're going to begin serving dinner. How does that sound? Everyone relax and enjoy.
Except I'm lying, because I'll be honest with you, my feet hurt. Before I know what women feel like now when they have corners. But I think it's time for me to get up and do a toast. So I won't say it now. I'll say it on my toast. I think I'm going to do a toast now. So you're going to get me in 30 seconds. Cut.
Well, if you raise your glass, and we'll do a real quick toast to David and Jacqueline. And I think it would be appropriate to tell you a little story. It's just going to be a little one.
Little story.
45
seconds.
I ain't got no bet with you, girl.
Yes, you do.
All right, anyway.
45 seconds. Your time.
Okay. I would like to say this. I've worked for David and known David actually in January the 3rd, which will be tomorrow, will be my 16th year. Year that I've worked for David. And so I've known David for just a little less than 16 years. And he's the kind of guy that I can tell you right now, obviously we know how successful he's been in the business world, but he's the type of guy that visualizes something that he wants and then he gets it. And I got to tell you, about 2 or 3 years ago, we were driving home from Miami, our resort in Miami. And it was, I don't know, maybe 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. We'd been down there working for 2 or 3 days. And David was telling me, he's driving the car and he says, you know, Jim, because, you know, you're 3 o'clock in the morning, you're driving home, man, you're doing man-to-man talk, you know. And he said, Jim, you know really what I like? You know really what I want? And I said, what? He goes, I think I want to get married and have children and do it all over one more time. He said, what I really like to find is a blonde, tall blonde, about 32 years old, tall blonde with big heart.
Hearts? Two hearts.
I got you on that one, didn't I? Let your mind wander. And have 2 or 3 more kids.
And that's exactly what he's done. Here I am sitting here two or three years later. Of course, I mean, we did all expect the wedding to come before the kids, but then again, they was always a little quicker than the rest of us. But
obviously.
But here it is, January the 2nd, 2000, their wedding date. And I have to say that, David, everybody here wishes you and Jacqueline success in the future. And we know, especially the people that have had children, that God's greatest gift to you is your children. So good luck to your new life and good luck to your new family. And cheers to both of you and much happiness to everybody.
Hey. Hey. Hey.
Good evening, I'm Richard Siegel, and you're not. Actually, I'm Richard, son of David, grandson of Sid. We're gathered here today for this historical event, the wedding of his mother, younger than myself. This is the younger brother, I'm the younger son, and his wife is younger than both of us.
And that means that Jessica is my sister-in-law.
Jessica, Barry and Jesse are related.
Exactly. And that Jacqueline's parents are my step-parents.
And Jacqueline's father is my grandfather.
And that David is your uncle.
Right.
No,
my brother. David's my brother dad. David.
David is your
David
brother.
David Alexander, right. My brother.
Right, no, David is Brandon's uncle.
Right. Now that we got that straight, let me just say that I hope both of us, are we both on here? We both hope that you, both of us, you have, both of us, B-O-F-U-S,
both of us,
that you have many, many, many great years and lots more children to share the inheritance with. Don't get offended over my toast now. You start, Steve. Right? Dad and Jacqueline. Congratulations, Jacqueline. You make the second best mom that I had. Dad,
we knew this was going to be a little boring, so I jumped in.
Third
best mother.
Love you.
And we wish you many, many years.
And
as happy, if you're as happy as the two of us, then that'll be something.
And if you need a nanny, you know I'm very expensive and I'll pay you.
Yeah, no. Anyway, never mind. So, congratulations, and many years to come.
Welcome to our new son.
We're very happy, and we hope our David and Jacqueline have many children and a happy, long life together.
Dave, Jacqueline, I wish you the love and lots of happiness and a very happy life. And a long life with both of you. Love you. Norm, Betty.
David, may you and Jackie be as happy as Beverly and I in the last 25 years. Good luck to you. You deserve it.
Hi.
We wish you a great marriage.
And a happy new year. Congratulations. We love you.
What I am going to say, I'm going to say it from the bottom of my heart. I love Jacqueline like I love the sister I never had, but I have one on her. She's an angel, she's beautiful, she's wonderful, she's not selfish. She's everything that I am in a blonde. And I wish her the best, her and David a good life, full of lots of love, lots of success, and most of all, to have lots of peace and God to give them divine light in front of them to do everything they ever want in life. Thank you.
Oh, I know. Hi, I'm Karen King, and this is for you, Jacqueline and David. Jacqueline, I love you dearly. You're my friend for a long time, and we've been through a lot, and now I look at you and you've got everything that I knew that you deserved and that you needed in your life. You have beautiful babies and you have a beautiful man that loves you and that you love him, and that's what it's all about. And I told you that a long time ago, and I'm so happy that you found that love that you needed, the same that I have found. I love you, Jack, and I love you, David. And I wish both of you, well, you've got everything. I mean, the only thing I could wish for is that you just stay beautifully in love and happy, and everything blessed on the two of you, as it is on Chacha and I. I love you.
Jacqueline and David, I am honored to be here on the day of your wedding. And may your first child be a masculine one.
Well, he is.
Oh, you've done that already. So, may your second child be a healthy child and give you all the happiness that you deserve. Buonasera, buonasera.
Hi, we'd like to say congratulations to Jacqueline and David.
Different wedding.
Hey, guys.
Hi, guys.
Thank you so much for all the hospitality that you've shown us. We love you so much.
We love it here.
We've only been married a couple of months, and we're happy you're in the same boat now. We're looking forward to spending many more couple of times with you.
Many more times above the garage.
Thank you. We love you. Congratulations.
Love you guys. Thanks.
See you later, dear.
I'm giving you a star from the heavens above as a token of my eternal love and my affection for you. Because once upon a time, I wished upon a star that I would find a special man who would love me more than, anything. And tonight my dream has come true. So tonight you own more than a company. You own my heart, and you own this particular star. The name of our star, the 14th star in the constellation Delphinus, is registered today and forever is named David and Jacqueline Siegel. And the reason I picked this star is because it has a planet circling around it. And I thought that when you run out of real estate timeshare here, you can start timesharing the planet around this star.
Special, and I wish I could spend time with every one of you here tonight, but we wouldn't leave here until 6 o'clock in the morning if I did that. So
I just want to thank you. If I don't get around to seeing you all, I want to thank you all for being here, and you all made this night very special for both of us. Thank you.
Video. Do you hear us?
I just want to wish you a very happy wedding and happy forever. I don't know what else to say.
My kids would have come tonight.
They got to go to school.
They got to go to school tomorrow, but they wish you and Jacqueline, they like Jacqueline very much, and they wish you both a happy and healthy marriage. And I'm sure that we're going to have a lot of good years together, and I'm very proud of you. Even though this is my lovely wife, and we're just very happy for you. And
hope you have as good a time as we do.
Hope you have as good a time and drink as much. Thank you for the good champagne.
Yeah. Thank you for everything.
Well, thank you for everything.
You're great.
It's very good. Jacqueline's got very, very good taste.
She does.
Fortunately, better than what you have, because we'd probably be drinking.
David, who has?
David.
Oh, God.
Probably be drinking cheap champagne with David.
Corbel.
Probably drinking Corbel with David.
Oh.
Jacqueline's got very good taste, and thank you very much. Cool. And we wish you both, from the bottom of our heart, our children's heart, we wish you the best forever. Thank you.
A long and happy.
On behalf of the table, David, we'd like to say thank you very much for inviting us. And from the bottom of our hearts, we wish you much, much happiness and health. And thank you so much for having us being here.
Congratulations.
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 Thank you a lot of wine.
I just want to say, David, we are all here tonight to wish you the best in your new adventure. And we also want to say we have Rich Roddy here from the Tax Assessor's Office, who has already started asking the question, Jackie Star, and how that is going to be assessed at Orange County. We feel that's very important to us at Orange County, to make sure we get all the tax resources we can get. But David, we love you. Everyone at the table loves you. Wish you the best. You got a great-looking family, and we love you. Thanks.
David, Jackie, we're proud of you. David, I always knew when you grew up you'd do well, and it finally has happened. So congratulations. You got a beautiful family, and the future looks bright, doesn't it, my friend?
David and Jacqueline, congratulations on the occasion of your wedding. It's been a wonderful evening, and in spite of what Commissioner Freeman says over here, this property really is very dumpy. It's not worth anything, so don't worry about your taxes.
Can you see
First of all, I think everyone will agree with me that this is the best wedding we've been to this millennium, right? Yeah. Of course, the millennium's only 2 days old, but it's still a great occasion. I think everybody did a fantastic job. Congratulations to all the staff at Westgate Lakes. Beautiful, beautiful job. I want to ask my father a question. Is it true that if Y2K had knocked out the power here, you would have flown all the guests to Hawaii and done the ceremony there?
Cut off the lights.
I want to welcome Jacqueline. I want to welcome Jacqueline and all of the Mallorys and her family into our family. And if Jacqueline, if your family's as dysfunctional as ours, they'll fit right in.
You too, Steve.
Also, on behalf of my brother Richard and myself, we hope that my father and Jacqueline's fortune increases faster than their offspring. And finally,
I didn't say that.
Finally, I'm done. I have an old Irish toast I'd like to propose. And it goes like this. Everybody raise your glasses. Dad and Jacqueline, may all your ups and downs be only between the sheets. Salute.
All right, we're going to do two for the price of one. We're going to turn things over to Michael Martyr, who is going to propose one more toast. This is a toast to certainly one of my best friends, David, and his lovely bride, Jacqueline. David, you are such a lucky man to have married a woman with such wonderful qualities. 36, 22, 34. Wow. And Jacqueline, I don't think you realize that you haven't married one man, actually have married five men rolled into one. First, there is David, the aspiring actor. His first role, film role, was as a pizza boy in the movie Parent Trap. Parenthood. Sorry. More recently, David had a starring role with Dennis Hopper as a police detective in a movie known as Ransom. Actually, the title to the movie was taken from David's last divorce case. And then there was David, the police detective. No, he was a deputy sheriff in Miami in the early 60s, where he was a renowned crime fighter. And one evening, the captain of the police force pulled up behind a parked car, only to find David asleep behind the wheel. And that ended his police career. He then moved to Orlando, and the rest is history, because he became very successful. And his greatest success was finding you. And we know David to be just a great guy, a wonderful humanitarian. And we wish you, Chris and I, long life, health, and happiness.
gentlemen, we have one final toast for you to listen to here this evening. So we need everybody's attention up here front and center. We're going to welcome up to the stage this time, Richard Siegel. Richard, come on up.
Hello, everybody. May I have your attention, please? We have one final toast for the bride and groom. Where is the bride going? Mr. Siegel, could you sit your bride down now? You're in charge. You're now married. You're in charge. That's why I never got married. Ready? It's 10. It's 11 o'clock on a Sunday night. What are we all doing here? Well, it's Dad and Jacqueline's wedding. So let's give them a cheer. You see, he's in the business of selling time. Something he's mastered his whole life. But now he's going to be sharing a lot of time with his playmate, his soulmate, his wife. La da di da. La da di da di da. Okay, let's go on to the next part. Get yourself a bride. You're the timeshare man. Get you a bride for life. Okay, I'm messing up a little bit. It's better than giving out 200 mil like you did with your last wife. Now you all throw quite a party. The decor, the food, and the guests. 500 of your closest friends. There wasn't enough room for the rest. We all have to recognize Grandma. 91, that's a lot. If my dad keeps giving her grandchildren, she'll tell him to tie it in a knot. La da di da. La da di da da da. Jacqueline keeps popping them out. Have yourself more kids, you the timeshare man. Go forth and populate. If you divide the inheritance anymore, I'll end up with $1.98. We all have to mention Adrian, who worked on this wedding night and day. And let's hear it for Bob, chef, and staff. Everyone say thank you with a hey! Hey! All right, here we go. If you are part of the family, acknowledge it with a yeah. A yeah. I thought there was some family out there. Let's hear it for all the personal friends. You can acknowledge it with a bah. Thank you. Something had to rhyme with the yeah, you know. Lots of employees are also here. They help foot the bill. If it's timeshare you want to buy, I'm sure they'll give you a great deal. We have a few more lines. So la da di da. Employees all say yeah. All the employees say yeah. There's a few in here. Make us some money, you the timeshare man. Make all of our dreams come true. I'm getting the hang of this now. None of us would be sitting here if it wasn't for you. It's a pretty good party for a Sunday night. 2000 was 2 days ago. Jacqueline is 1 year younger than me. Dad likes him young for show. But on behalf of Dave and Jacqueline, thank you all for being here. Say thank you to all of them. Raise your glasses and give them a cheer. La. The bride and groom, toast it with a bottle of Dom. This song was written for all of you, but especially for my dad and new mom. And thanks for all you do, especially for everything else too. We hope you're together for many moons because we all love you. Congratulations. Here's to you. Thank you.
We are going to move things along, bring the bride and groom on up here to the dance floor because it is time for the bouquet and garter ceremony. So we need the bride and groom on up here to the front. Oh, we got a chair. Look at that. Okay, come on over here. We got a couple questions for you. Do you know what you're looking for?